Welcome back to Hot Copy. We're talking with Labor Secretary Rosalinda Baldos. Okay, question from Facebook. Jonalyn Leasing asks, paano na po yan pag magbabakasyon ako? Hindi na ako makakabalik sa amo ko. Dito po ako ngayon sa Lebanon. Ganda ng tanong. Paano yun, ma?
Okay, so actually ngayon, ang Lebanon may existing ba naman tayo sa domestic helper talaga? So I don't know kung is he a household service worker there.
Definitely household. May amo eh.
So, yun, kung babalik talaga siya, ban yung deployment dahil up to now, meron tayong existing ban, not necessarily in relation to the this board resolution, but even earlier, meron na tayong ban
so,
sa Lebanon.
So, technically, noon pa man, banned na ang workers from going to Lebanon.
Yes, yes.
Pag umuwi siya ng Pilipinas, hindi siya makaalis.
Yes, yes.
So, isn't, kumbaga tanong ko ma'am, isn't the ban a negative in a way because it discourages Filipinos from coming back home? Ang mangyayari, they will remain there kasi nandun ang trabaho.
Well, I would presume that those who would like to remain and go back would have employers who are treating them well.
Yes.
Otherwise, they will, the contract ends, they will have to come back.
No, but it's Christmas. Definitely, they'll want to come back. Even if I had a good employer, I'd want to come home for Christmas. So I am at risk of losing my job.
But it's their option, really. It's their option that they
no,
can
but
stay
you
there.
Will not allow them to fly back.
No, it's their option to really stay there because the ban really would prohibit those going there. So
kaya nga.
Yes.
So let's say, ma'am, nandun ako.
Yes.
Domestic helper ako sa Lebanon. Yung amo ko mabait. Pero uuwi ako ng Pasko. Tatlong araw lang o apat na araw. Hindi na ako makakabalik.
So, sa ngayon, under the existing ban, then ganun ang mangyayari.
Ah, masaklap pala. Hindi,
That's why we need to really negotiate the bilateral agreement.
Ma'am, ang tanong ko what makes this difficult is not for the new deployees eh.
Mm-hmm.
It's those na nandun na na maayos naman ang working condition, with a ban, the government, in a way, is discouraging them to come home because they will not want to lose their jobs.
Well, that's one aspect that we are looking. At the level of, say, of the countries, there could be some deficiencies in the law, but at the level of the individual employer, there could be no problem, especially for those who have stayed for one employer for quite a number of years, then there are no records of exploitation, abuses, or contract violations. So that is one area where the board will look into in terms of maybe giving way to some relaxation on the impact of a ban.
Yeah, because definitely, like for example, Gaddafi is hated worldwide. Mm. He was a dictator. But when you talk sa mga kasambahay ni Gaddafi, ang bait-bait niya, maganda pagkatrato sa amin.
Yes.
So like for example, yung mga kasambahay na yun na nandito, if they want to go back to Libya, they cannot with a ban.
Right now, the ban for Libya still stays because of security reasons naman, no? And it is being assessed now. So right now, even hindi nga yung mga household workers are being advised na to wait for a while until the security situation has been assessed and the FA has given us the necessary advice that it is already safe. Right now, this has nothing to do with the non-compliant
But wouldn't Libya be safer now? I mean, given that Gaddafi is dead, I would assume Libya would be opening its doors.
Yes, that is the general presumption, but we still have to look on how established already is the new government.
Okay.
And I think the FA is already doing that assessment, and in due time, we expect to already receive some advice on how to handle the deployment of OFWs. But I'm not in charge of the security assessment, and we have to be guided by what the FA will tell us.
Okay. All right. Questions from my Twitter account, RB Bautista. Di po ba ito makaka-apekto sa diplomatic relations natin sa 41 countries?
Well, ang nag-issue kasi nito is the FA themselves, the different ambassadors in the countries. We've been asking at the board if there have been some consultation, and we were made to understand that they issued the certification and we have to abide by the certification. But right now, since the board resolution will take effect 15 days from publication, I understand POA published the board as required by law today. If there would be some problems that could pose some difficulty in the implementation, and there could be request that a reasonable time could still be given beyond the 15-day period, then I think the board will be open for any such request and justification for a longer time before it is implemented.
All right. I am Tuki. Will the government compensate those who will lose their jobs as a result of these measures?
The idea is even if this is effective, the existing contract will continue until it expires. So there's no damage whatsoever.
So let's say domestic helper.
Yeah.
May kontrata siya sa amo.
2 years, for example.
2 years.
Or 1 year
tapos,
pa lang na-serve
niya. Okay, uuwi siya dito ngayong Pasko. Ang kailangan lang niya dalhin yung kontrata niya, papalipa pa rin niyo siyang Lebanon.
Yeah, because we have to respect the contract, the complete term of the contract.
All right. Okay, that's a good point. Ami Katche, what will happen to the OFWs already working in these countries?
Well, they continue to finish the contracts that they have signed with the employer. And if they are working with an international and companies with global operations, then they are not affected.
Okay.
The ban does not apply to them.
Robbie Mark P, is Malaysia included in the 41 countries?
I don't think so.
I don't think so either. Yeah. But how's the track record with Malaysia?
I think we send some
hotels.
Also in the garments factory, and basically they are supervisors. But we also send household service workers.
We do. All right. This question, Sheng Son, is Brunei included in the list?
No, I don't think so.
Okay. But countries like Brunei, for example, do we have a bilateral agreement with Brunei?
I don't remember if we have.
Isn't that unfair that there are some countries magkakaroon ng ban dahil walang bilateral agreement, and some countries porket lang mayaman sila? You know what I mean?
I don't think that will be the measure, because the law very specific in the requirements for purposes of DFA certification. It has nothing to do whether the country is rich or not. It has something to do with those at least one of the three conditions plus the other one, which is the concrete measures of protection.
But why is it there are no countries in the Middle East that are in the ban, considering a lot of the horrific stories are from the Middle East?
Because we have not yet deliberated on the DFA certification. That will have to await for the next issuance of the governing board. There is no decision yet, and the DFA certification will have to be discussed at the board.
Okay. Susan Ople, why did the previous administration let this law lapse without signing it?
I'm not privy. I was not in the overseas employment anymore at the time that the law was deliberated and finally passed. It took effect in 2009.
Okay. All right, ma'am, your last words to everyone watching. I mean, some of them might be feeling nervous.
Yes.
You know, can you assure them?
Yes. I mean, what you can assure at this point in time is this non-compliant certification issued to 41 countries is very temporary. At any given point in time, we expect that should they feel, any of the countries feel na kailangan nilang ating mga OFWs, even especially those working in their local companies, then this will be a good avenue to enter into
an agreement,
things like that. But with respect to the majority of our OFWs working in this, actually 22 of the 41 countries ang merong international operations na mga company, the law itself says that this non-certification of certification of non-compliance, hindi sila maapektuhan. So they'll continue to work with the companies, be it in the chain, in international chains of hotel, international construction company, gas and oil exploration companies.
At kung may existing contract,
kung may existing contract ngayon, kahit merong ganitong non-compliance yung bansa, they will continue to complete until the contract expires.
Basta the OFW is treated well.
Treated well, okay.
All right. Good day to you, Secretary Valdez. Thank you for coming. And that's Head Start today. I hope you learned something. I'm Karen Davila. Have a good day, everyone. I'll see you again tomorrow.